Hi students, welcome to Nellanad Advice YouTube channel. Students, today topic is motion along one dimension. So the motion along one dimension means, so in this video we are going to discuss about the motion of the particle along the only one direction. Okay students, so the first topic is average velocity. If a particle moves in one dimension, say for example along the x direction, we consider one particle is moves along the x direction. So we are going to calculate the average velocity of the particle. So already last class, that is the last video, we have discussed the average velocity. The average velocity is defined as ratio of the displacement vector to the corresponding time interval. So the average velocity for the one dimensional motion, it is also written by the del x divided by del t. Del x means that is the displacement vector. Okay, the displacement along the x axis. That is a change in the x-axis. Okay, that is del x divided by del t. Del t means that is a change in a time. Change in time means that is a time interval. Okay, students. So the average velocity is equal to del x divided by del t. So the del x means already I told to you that is a difference between the initial position and the final position. So here we take that is x2 minus x1. That is the difference between the initial position and the final position. That is x2 minus x1 divided by del t means there is a change in time. That is the difference between the initial time and the final time. That is t2 minus t1. So the average velocity is also a vector quantity. Okay, so already you know the velocity is a vector quantity. So the average velocity is also one of the vector quantity. But in one dimension, we have only two direction. That is a positive direction and another one is negative x direction. Okay, one is positive x direction and another one is negative x direction. Okay, so along the one dimension, here it has two direction only. It is either positive or negative. Hence, we use positive and negative sign to denote the direction. So the instantaneous velocity or velocity defined as v is equal to limit del t gives 0 del x divided by del t, it is also equal to dx divided by dt. So here this formula, it is also graphically shown. That is the graphically the slope of the position time graph will give the velocity of the particle. Okay. Right, graphically the velocity is given by the figure 2.35. At the same time, if the velocity time graph is given, the distance and the displacement are determined by calculating area under the curve. Okay, students. So by using this velocity time graph, we can calculate the area under the curve. It is also given the value of the displacement. It is also given the value of the displacement. Okay, from the graph between the velocity and the time, we can calculate the area under the curve. It is also given the distance and the displacement of the particle. So we know that the velocity is given by the formula, that is dx divided by dt. It is also equal to v. Therefore, we can write what is the values of the dx. Dx means the displacement. The dx is equal to v into dt. V into dt. So we can calculate the displacement. Students, by integrating both sides, this equation is modified to, okay, in the left hand side, it want to be integrated with respect to displacement, that is x. Okay, so initially this object, it has a position is x1, finally it has a position is x2. So in left hand side, it is integral of x1 to x2 dx is equal to, here the right side, it want to be integrated with respect to time. Okay, initially this object, it has a time is t1, finally it has a time is t2. So on right hand side, it will be modified to integral of t1 to t2 v into dt. Students, check it here. By integrating both sides, we get integral of x1 to x2 dx is equal to integral t1 to t2 v into dt. So as already seen, integration is equivalent to area under the given curve. The integration is equivalent to area under the given curve. So the term integral t1 to t2 v into dt represent the area under the curve v as a function of time. Okay, students. So here the integration, it is also given the area under the curve. So the area under the curve will give the displacement traveled by the particle. Okay, so you know here the left hand side, it has the values is integral of x1 to x2 dx, means this is one of the distance traveled by the particle, that is a displacement. So here the right hand side, that is integral t1 to t2 v into dt, means that is the area under the curve, the area under the curve. So the area, the integration is equivalent to the area under the curve is given. Okay, it is also given the displacement of the particle. Okay, students, right. Since the left hand side of the integration represent the displacement traveled by the particle from the time t1 to t2, the right hand side, that is the area under the velocity time graph, will give the displacement of the particle. If the area is negative, it means that the displacement is negative. So the particle has traveled in the negative direction. Okay, you can check in the diagram. Here this is for the positive displacement. Suppose the graph, it is given in the negative, means what is the meaning? The area under the curve is in negative. If it is negative, means the displacement is negative. Okay. So if the area is negative, it means that the displacement is negative. So the particle has traveled in the negative direction. Okay, students. Next, relative velocity in 1 and 2 dimensional motion. What is the meaning for relative velocity? Relative velocity means when two objects A and B are moving with different velocities, then the velocity of one object A with respect to another object B is called relative velocity of object A with respect to object B. Students, have you understood what is the meaning for the relative velocity? Relative velocity means when the two objects A and B are moving with different velocities, then the velocity of one object A with respect to the another object B is called relative velocity of object A with respect to object B. So consider two objects A and B moving with uniform velocity VA and VB. In case 1, we are going to discuss the two objects having the velocity is the same, that is a uniform velocity. Okay, that is a VA and VB. It is also shown in the figure. Okay, along this straight track in the same direction, VA vector, VB vector with respect to the ground. The relative velocity of the object is given by the students. Case 1. Here, consider the two objects A and B moving with uniform velocity VA and VB. Okay, here it has the velocity is VA, here it has the velocity is VB. Both are having the uniform velocity. Okay, students. So it is also travel in a straight track in the same direction, VA vector, VB vector with respect to the ground. Okay, so the relative velocity of object A with respect to object B, the relative velocity of the object A with respect to object B, it is also given by the VAB vector is equal to VA vector minus VB vector. So the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A, it is also given by the VBA, that is the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A. So only it is given by the VBA vector is equal to VB minus VA. Okay, VB minus VA. Thus, if the two objects are moving in the same direction, the magnitude of the relative velocity of the object with respect to another is equal to the difference in magnitude of the two velocity. Okay, here the velocity is a uniform velocity, but the two objects are moving with a different velocity. Okay, it is moves in the same direction, but a different velocity. So we can calculate Here the magnitude of the relative velocity of one object with respect to another object is equal to the difference in magnitude of the two velocities. Next, case 2. Consider the two objects A and B moving with uniform velocity VA and VB along the same straight track but in opposite direction. So like this, here the VA vector and VB vector, it is moves in opposite direction, means the relative velocity of the object A with respect to object B is given by the relative velocity of the object A. So VAB vector is equal to VA vector minus here minus VB vector, because here this negative sign is indicate this velocity of the object. Here like this, the object B, it is moves opposite direction to the object A. So VA vector minus into minus VB vector. In next step, it can be written as minus into minus plus. So VA vector plus VB vector. So the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A, it can be calculated by using the formula of VBA vector is equal to minus VB vector minus VA vector. So we can take the negative sign on outside, means it can be written as minus into VA plus VB vector. Thus, if two objects are moving in opposite direction, the magnitude of the relative velocity of one object with respect to another object is equal to sum of the magnitude of the velocity. See then, here the velocity, relative velocity of the object with respect to B, that is a VA vector plus VB vector. Here is also the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A, that is minus into VA plus VB vector. So we can write, if the two objects are moving in the opposite direction, then the magnitude of the relative velocity of one object with respect to another is equal to sum of the magnitude of the velocity. Next, case 3. Consider the velocity VA vector and VB vector at an angle theta between their directions. The relative velocity of object A with respect to object B is given by the VAB vector is equal to VA vector minus VB vector. Then the magnitude and direction of VAB vector is given by the magnitude VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB cos theta. Already you know the formula for the magnitude of the vector. Okay students, so you can write that. Next, for calculate the direction, we are calculate the turn beta. Turn beta is equal to VB sin theta divided by VA minus VB cos theta. Here the beta is the angle between the VAB vector and VB vector. Students, when theta is equal to 0 degree, the bodies move along parallel straight line in the same direction. We know that, okay? So the two bodies are moving in a same direction, so it is a parallel to each other, okay, when theta is equal to 0 degree. So we can calculate the relative velocity of object A with respect to B, means here it has a formula VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB cos theta. So here theta is equal to 0 degree, so already you know the values for the cos 0 degree. Cos 0 degree is equal to 1. It is a subset in this equation, means that VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB into 1. So we can write the VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB. So it is in the form of the A square plus B square minus 2AB. So it can be written as A minus B whole square. So VAB is equal to square root of VA minus VB whole square. In next step, it can be written as VAB is equal to VA minus VB. Students, by using this, we can calculate the values of the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A. Already we know that the relative velocity of the object B with respect to A, that is VBA is equal to minus VAB. So that equation is substituted in this value. So we can write the VBA is equal to minus into VA minus VB, means it will become as VBA is equal to VB minus VA. Okay students, so obviously we can get VBA is equal to VB minus VA. It is along the direction of the VB vector.
Here the VAB, it is along the direction of the VA vector. Okay, students. Next, when theta is equal to 180 degree, the body moves along parallel straight line in opposite direction. Okay, theta is equal to 180 degree means here the two bodies are moves in opposite direction. So we can calculate the value of the relative velocity of the object A with respect to B. That is VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB cos 180 degree. Okay, so already you know the values of the cos 180 degree, it is equal to minus 1. So VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB into minus 1. So it will become as square root of VA square plus VB square plus minus into minus plus. So 2VAVB. So it is in the form of the a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, so it can be written as a plus b whole square. Okay, so now this is simplified to va plus vb whole square, square root of va plus vb whole square. So vab is equal to va plus vb. So you can calculate the relative velocity of the object b with respect to a means that is vba is equal to vb plus va, vb plus va. Okay, students, right? So next, if the two bodies are moving at a right angle to each other, then theta is equal to 90 degree. So we can calculate the magnitude of the relative velocity of the object A with respect to B. That is VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square. Okay, right. When theta is equal to 90 degree, you know the values for the cos 90 degree is equal to 0. It is substituting this equation means VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square minus 2VAVB into 0. So this term is 0. So final answer is VAB is equal to square root of VA square plus VB square. Okay, so next, consider a person moving horizontally with velocity Vm vector. Okay, this is a velocity of the man, that is Vm vector. Let rain fall vertically with velocity Vr vector. Okay, the velocity of the rain, it is not a letter Vr. So rain fall vertically with velocity Vr vector. An umbrella is held to avoid the rain. Then the relative velocity of the rain with respect to the person is. Okay, we can calculate the relative velocity of the rain with respect to person. That is Vrm is equal to Vr vector minus Vm vector, which has the magnitude, that is Vrm is equal to root of Vr square plus Vm square. Okay, so we know that here it is acting perpendicular to each other. Okay, so theta is equal to 90 degree. So we can calculate the relative velocity, that is Vrm is equal to root of Vr square plus Vm square. And the direction theta is equal to turn inverse of Vm divided by Vr. Okay, so in order to save himself from the rain, he should hold an umbrella at angle theta with the vertical. Okay. Students, next, accelerated motion. During non-uniform motion of an object, the velocity of the object changes from instant to instant. Okay, what is the meaning for the velocity of the object changes from instant to instant? That is, the velocity of the object is no more constant, but changes with the time. With respect to time, it is changes continuously. Okay, such a motion is said to be an accelerated motion. Okay, so the velocity of the object is changes continuously with respect to time. That a motion is called accelerated motion. In accelerated motion, if the change in velocity of object per unit time is the same. Okay, if the change in the velocity of the object per unit time is same, that is a constant, then the object is said to be moving with uniformly accelerated motion. Okay, it is changes continuously with respect to time, that is called accelerated motion. So in this accelerated motion, if the change in the velocity of the object per unit time is the same, then the object is said to be moving with uniformly accelerated motion. Next, in the motion, if the change in the velocity per unit time is different at a different time. If the change in the velocity per unit time is different
at different times, then the object is said to be moving with non-uniform accelerated motion. Okay, students. Next, average acceleration. If an object changes its velocity from v1 vector to v2 vector in a time interval delta t is equal to t2 minus t1, then the average acceleration is defined as the ratio of change in velocity over the time interval delta t is equal to d2 minus d1. Already you know, okay, so acceleration is calculated by using the formula of rate of change of velocity. So here the average acceleration is noted by the a average vector is equal to, that is the ratio between the velocity and the time, that is v2 vector minus v1 vector divided by t2 minus t1. So here you know that what is the meaning for v2 minus v1, that is the difference between the velocity, difference between the velocity, initial velocity and the final velocity. So we can write that is the change in velocity, that is the del v vector divided by d2 minus d1, means that is the difference between the time interval. So we can write the reason of the del t. So here the average acceleration a average vector is equal to del v vector divided by del t. Average acceleration is a vector quantity in the same direction as the vector del v vector. Next, instantaneous acceleration. Usually the average acceleration will give the change in the velocity only over the entire time interval. Okay, only the average acceleration will give the change in the velocity only over the entire time interval. It will not give value of the acceleration at any instant of. So the instantaneous acceleration or acceleration of the particle at a time t is given by the ratio of change in velocity over the time interval del t. So as del t approaches zero, we can write the acceleration a vector is equal to limitation del t gives zero. The del t approaches zero means there is a limitation del t gives zero. Del v vector divided by del t. So it is also equal to here the del v vector divided by del t means it can be written as that is a dv vector divided by dt. Dv vector divided by dt. That is a change in velocity divided by change in time. So in other words, the acceleration of the particle at any instant t is equal to rate of change of velocity. Okay, the acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity. So here the acceleration is a vector quantity. Its SI unit is meter per second square. Already you know that is a meter second inverse square or meter per second square. And its dimensional formula is m power 0, l power 1, t power minus 2. That is one of the m naught l power 1, t inverse square. So the acceleration is positive if its velocity is increasing continuously. Okay, so here the acceleration is positive if its velocity is increasing continuously, and the acceleration is negative if the velocity is decreasing. If the acceleration is negative, if the velocity is decreasing. So the negative acceleration is called retardation or declaration. Okay, the negative acceleration is called retardation or declaration. So here in terms of components, we can write the acceleration a vector is equal to dvx divided by dt I cap plus dvy divided by dt j cap plus dvz divided by dt k cap. It is also equal to dv vector divided by dt. Thus ax means that is a components along the x-axis, that is ax is equal to dvx divided by dt. Ay means that is a dvy divided by dt. Az means that is a dvz divided by dt are the components of the instantaneous acceleration, are the components of the instantaneous acceleration. Since each component of velocity is the derivative of the corresponding coordinate, we can express the components ax, ay and az as ax is equal to d square x divided by dt square I cap, ay is equal to d square y divided by dt square, az is equal to d square z divided by dt square. Then the acceleration vector a vector itself is a vector is equal to d square x divided by dt square I cap plus d square y divided by dt square j cap plus d square z divided by dt square k cap. It is also equal to d square r vector divided by dt square. The r vector means there is a position. Okay, students, right?
acceleration is the second derivative of position. Acceleration is the second derivative of the position vector. Okay, so the acceleration is the second derivative of the position vector with respect to time. So graphically, the acceleration is the slope in the velocity time graph. Graphically, the acceleration is the slope in the velocity time graph. At the same time, if the acceleration time graph is given, then the velocity can be found from the area under the acceleration time graph. From we can write dv divided by dt is equal to a. We have dv is equal to a into dt. Hence, we can calculate the values of the v from the dv by integration. Okay, so here the v is equal to integral of t1 to t2 a into dt. For an initial time t1 and a final time t2.